Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to be showing you everything that I eat in a day. As a vegan, I feel like all of my vlogs start out like this, but I started out my day with yoga and then took a shower. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, I do plan the days that I vlog around clean hair days, so whatever. But I'm going to go downstairs and start making my pre-breakfast drinks now, so let's go. Alright, so I got my water for my tea. I used one of these, where's the lid? Instead of using, the tea balls for loose leaf tea, I use one of these things. So you, push this down and pour the tea out. But anyways, I'm just going to start heating this up and pour it in my pot. And today, actually, I've been having this tea almost every day recently. It's by Reishi Tea. It's Omija Berry Blush. It's kind of like a fruity tea, but there's, some lavender in there, too. So I really like that. And then, as always, I have to have my green drink, so I'm just going to mix this with a little bit of water in my mug. And then, also, I'm going to have a chaga latte using the Four Sigmatic chaga packet with some cashew milk and cinnamon. I showed you guys how to make this in a video, maybe a month or so ago. This video, as well as that last one, was and is sponsored by Four Sigmatic, but I'm actually going to talk about that a little bit later, but I'm going to make all of these drinks and then sip on those, and then I'll show you guys what I'm making for breakfast. All right, I have decided I'm going to make a sort of golden milk yogurt bowl for breakfast. I'm going to be using this yogurt. It's based on a pili nut and coconut. This one is just the original. There's no added sugar or anything. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to add some protein powder to it. And then I'm also going to add some flaxseed. And then to make it golden milk, I have this in my pantry and I should probably use it up. It's just like a blend of turmeric with other spices. Let's see if it focuses. All right, there you go. And then for my fruity toppings, I'm going to add an apple, and then I have some pomegranate that I use for a different recipe, so I'll probably sprinkle a little bit of that on top. So I'll show you once it's finished. Okay, and here we have the final stylized shot. I hid a bunch of apple in there under the yogurt, but I still have a little bit left. I'm going to top my bowl with that, and I'll probably save the pomegranate for another day. But this is the yogurt bowl. I decided to be extra and actually set up a photo for it for my YouTube thumbnail. To be completely honest, my breakfast does not look like this every day. I used to go through a phase where I felt like I had to photograph every meal, but I definitely don't need to do that. I have better things to do with my life in terms of work, things that I need to get done. And it's not like I'm posting every single meal on Instagram either. So I just photograph the nice ones or when I feel like treating myself. But if this was an average day, I would say I would just plop everything in a bowl, probably not even a pretty bowl, and just mix it up and eat it like that while I answered emails or something. So, you know, just keeping it real. Also, true life, anyone who designs food things, obviously I can't mix these into my bowl, but I like apples, so I like to dip them or just eat them by themselves. So I'm gonna eat this, and I'll check in with you guys the next time I eat some food. But in the meantime, I've got some work I need to do. I'm stressed. So I haven't really shared this with you guys yet, but this is a very busy time in my life right now. I just got back from my trip abroad, and I haven't said this on YouTube, but I'm actually moving. I'm leaving Miami at the end of this month, and I feel like time's just creeping up on me, and then when I start moving, I'm not going to be able to move into my new place for a while, so I'm not gonna be able to work for a while, so I'm trying to get ahead, but I also got sick and I just have a lot of work that I need to do, and I'm just letting it slowly pile up on me and I'm getting stressed out. But anyways, I've just been sitting on my computer editing some videos, so yeah, I don't know where I'm going with. So I just feel like I've been letting things get to me a little bit more than usual, and things that normally wouldn't bother me or faze me have been taking a toll on me, and I just feel very anxious and high stress right now. But anyways, it's lunchtime and I don't really feel like making lunch, so I'm just gonna whip something up.
Okay, so I made myself an upgraded everything bagel. When I was a kid in high school, I'd say my breakfast most days was a toasted everything bagel with cream cheese and a glass of orange juice. I don't have the orange juice today, but I made an everything bagel and I put it, topped it with vegan cream cheese by Kite Hill and some pickled red onions and some basil because I was lying on my fridge. And then I also chopped up some cucumber and I have some baba ganoush. I made this recipe a while ago and then I froze it because I went on my trip and then I came back and have it. It's kind of funky now, but it still tastes okay. The texture starts a little weird and I topped it with some more of those pomegranate seeds for breakfast. So this is going to be my lunch. Also want to know, dipping cucumber in baba ganoush is not traditional, but you know, I'm just trying to get some veggies in here, okay? Also, I will say I made this bagel combo earlier this week and it is really, really good. So you guys should try it out.
I have been testing some granola bars for my blog and I'm really happy with this one. It's going to be coming to the blog shortly. I like it because it's not sticky at room temperature, but I'm going to have this portion of a granola bar as an afternoon snack. So it's been a bit. I'm going to get started on my dinner now. And like I mentioned earlier, I am moving. And one of the things that's stressing me out is I have so much food. So I'm trying to challenge myself to use the food that I have and only buy fresh produce, but really be conscious about using up things that aren't in my pantry because I think I'm a closeted food hoarder. So I'm going to be making a very untraditional Thai curry for dinner tonight. So these are all the ingredients that I scrounged up. I have this curry paste in my fridge, so I want to use this up, and I have a bunch of cans of coconut milk, so that works out perfectly. I don't really have any traditional veggies though, so I'm going to be using some sweet potatoes, some carrots, some kale. I have a giant red onion, and then I'm also going to toss in this jackfruit. I have two boxes. The bags in it are kind of small, so I thought that would make things a little more interesting. And then on the side, I'm going to cook up some of this quinoa, and then I also think I'm going to make some crispy tofu. The recipe for this is on my blog, so I will link that, but honestly, I'm just gonna be winging the rest of this. I can kind of walk you through it though. So I chopped up all my veggies. I also found some cherry tomatoes, so I'm gonna add those into the curry as well, and I put my kale in a bowl. I'm gonna be adding it at the end, so it doesn't really matter. This is the jackfruit, and then I drained my tofu. I'll just squeeze a little bit of the liquid. Oh man, I'm doing the wrong burner. Man, this is what happens when you try to film and cook at the same time. Anyways, I'm supposed to be bringing my quinoa to a boil now that the correct burner is on. And I cut up my tofu, tossed it, like the recipe says, with some nutritional yeast and tamari. And I'm just waiting for the oven to preheat. And now in the bowl that I mixed the tofu in, I'm going to add in my jackfruit and just break it up a little with my hands. Also, I don't know why, but this stuff is always like red, whereas the canned stuff usually isn't.
Also, if you guys can hear in the background, recently I decided to listen to Taylor Swift's new album. When it first came out, I was like, oh, heck no. But then I listened to it and I was like, this actually isn't terrible, and I've been listening to it on repeat for like the past 3 or 4 days. So that's my musical obsession for the week, so I'm gonna listen to that while I cook.
Okay, so I have sauteed the onions until they're pretty translucent, and now I'm going to add in the curry paste and saute that for a few minutes to cook the flavors in this. Also, look how crazy that jackfruit looks. So I added all the veggies except for the kale. I'm just going to add that in at the end. And then now I'm going to add in the vegetable broth and the coconut milk, and I think I'm still going to need to add a little bit more liquid, but I'll probably just add water because all the flavors that I want are here, and if I add veggie broth, it's just going to get even more salty. So now that it is starting to simmer, I'm just going to reduce the heat to low and then let it cook for like 15 to 20 minutes or until the sweet potatoes are tender. Now I'm going to add in the kale and stir that around just so it cooks a little, but you know, it's hard to cook with one hand, guys. Got it. Now to stir that in. It looks so much prettier now that the kale is cooked in, though I will admit the pink jackfruit still kind of looks weird, but whatever. So the curry's done, the quinoa is done, and my tofu came out looking nice and crispy. So this is everything I'm gonna have for dinner. And I had some really limp looking cilantro left in my fridge, so I just chopped that up as a topping. And I have some lime wedges, and I'm just going to save the leftovers from these for my leftovers for the curry.
for another day.
But actually, it's only 4 p.m., so I'm not gonna eat my dinner right now. I go for evening walks and listen to podcasts, and recently I've been going before my dinner instead of after my dinner. Just has been working better with my schedule, and it's sort of a nice break between the work day and the evening. But when I get back, I'm always hungry, and I like to have my dinner ready. So usually I have leftovers, but tonight I didn't have leftovers, so I just made this ahead of time. And, you know, people say curry gets better with time anyways because the flavors get to mix together. So if it's not warm by the time I get back, I'll just reheat it. I'm back for my walk now, and I just rinsed off a little in the shower and wore my hair in this cute little updo because I try to aerate the back because I only like to wash it, like, once a week. But it's so hot in Miami, I sweat every time I go for a walk. It's like I did a full-on workout. I'm also wearing my favorite pajama shirt. But anyways, I already mixed my curry bowl together, so it doesn't look that cute, but it did look pretty at one point, I promise. So this is my dinner, and I'm also drinking a peach pear liqueur. I did want to talk about the concept of like eating food or diets like when you're stressed. Because I feel like they're kind of like different schools of thought, or some people are like, oh, you're stressed, you should treat yourself by eating all the junk food you want. And then there are other people who are like, when you're stressed, you should only fuel your body with the most nourishing thing. I don't think it's completely fine to treat yourself. And if you are feeling stressed out and you want to reward yourself with like a square of dark chocolate or like an extra dessert or chips or whatever, I mean, if that's what you want to do, I think that's totally fine. I just know sometimes when I used to be stressed, I would turn to like eating large quantities of junk food. I never think you should use, I guess, like unhealthy food as a crutch when you're stressed. I don't think you should use it as like a coping mechanism. I think you should first try to look at the problem and see why you're stressed and see if you can like take some deep breaths or do something else to like kind of overcome and confront the issue and not try to like mask it with food, I guess. But at the end of the day, there's nothing wrong with eating a little extra chocolate because it helps you feel a little bit better. On that note, I'm hungry, so I'm just gonna eat my dinner. But I will check in with you guys afterwards. The camera hasn't really moved, but I've actually been in the kitchen. I was testing a recipe for some tahini sugar cookies. So this is my first batch. So I'm going to be having one of these for dessert. I don't know. I guess I'll try and see if they're good enough. If not, I'll do some more testing tomorrow. And then I'm also having a few more pieces of that granola bar that I ate earlier. And then I'm also having a cup of herbal tea, and it's just an herbal tea that I had lying around downstairs. But I also added this Four Sigmatic Reishi mushroom elixir to it. I mentioned at the beginning of this video that this video is sponsored by Four Sigmatic, and in this video I wanted to talk about reishi because especially if you're feeling stressed or like you just need to chill, reishi is actually a really great mushroom for that. So it's an adaptogenic mushroom, which means it works with your body to help stabilize and bring you to the proper level that you need. And reishi is really good for helping you relax, and it also helps you sleep better at night. And I don't take this every single night, but on days when I am feeling like more stressed or I want to chill, I do take it in the evening. And honestly, guys, I do notice a difference when I sleep. I feel like I sleep deeper, and I also have more dreams. I don't know if it's just me. You guys can comment below, but personally, I definitely believe in like adaptogens and stuff like that. So I really like this. And if you want to get a 15% discount on anything on the Four Sigmatic website, you can use my code from my bowl, or you can go to their website at foursigmatic.com/from my bowl. I'll write it out right here, and I'll also link it in the description of this video. And I think that's it for this video. I hope you guys liked it. Let me know if you want me to film more casual what I eat in a day like this. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, whatever time of day it is for you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!